Imagine you wake up thinking, I had a wonderful night's sleep, I feel fantastic, and I'm going to get up immediately. If you're anything like me, that never happens. No matter how much sleep you get, there's always that niggling voice
just
inside your head.
More.
The snooze button, more alarms. The snooze button, and you thinking about how tired you are. The snooze button, but simply thinking you got a good night's sleep can improve your brain function. In a recent study, researchers told participants that those who spend more than 25% of their time asleep in REM sleep have better cognitive functioning. Last week I mentioned when we sleep, we cycle through stages of light and deep sleep. The first and second stages are light sleep, where we can be woken up easily. When you reach the third stage, you enter deep sleep, and following that is rapid eye movement, REM sleep, where your eyes actually move back and forth and you're most likely to dream. But the study was all a setup. Participants slept in a lab and researchers told some that they had 16% REM sleep and others that they had 29% REM sleep the night before. When they were tested for their attention spans and processing speeds, those told that they had above average REM sleep performed better, and those told they had below average performed worse. The researchers called the effect placebo sleep, because it's kind of like the placebo effect, where in medical treatments, a fake treatment, like a sugar pill, is given to a patient and it actually improves their condition because they believe it will help. In this case, simply believing that you had a good night's sleep, even if you didn't, improves performance. But can you really fake sleep? Not in the Homer Simpson way, but in the way where you actually believe you had more or better quality sleep the night before. It's totally unrealistic that you would sleep in a lab setting every night or you would have an expert with you every morning to say you slept well. That would be weird. But you could stop thinking and talking about how tired you are and plan a nap. Researchers say an afternoon nap is the ideal remedy for fatigue from sleep loss. Again, that's kind of unrealistic for those of us with jobs who aren't as brazen as George Costanza. One solution is called active rest or progressive muscle relaxation. You focus on one muscle group in your body, like your hands, make them really tense for about 15 seconds, then release and you do that up and down your body. You should feel recharged. Like napping, active rest improves our mood and is good for feelings of fatigue and your stress levels. Well, it's really hard to tell what the quality of your sleep was actually like. If you're feeling fatigued, you should snooze less and nap more. Or active rest. It's almost napping. So it seems that the key to faking sleep is actually faking sleep. In the Homer Simpson way. Chances are you've woken up feeling really drowsy and confused. Check out my video last week, which is an explainer on severe sleep inertia or sleep drunkenness. And if you've tried active rest instead of napping, let me know what that's like in the comments. Or if you haven't tried at work, and let me know how it goes, if you can get away with it. And if you haven't already, subscribe to BrainCraft. I have a new brainy video out every Thursday.